You want your applications to be reliable, but sometimes they are not. They may fail due to configuration errors, application errors, or temporary connection issues. Now, it's important to know the reason for the failure, but it's equally important to detect it immediately and recover your application. We know that the easiest way to fix something is to restart it. Well, the liveness probe allows us to do exactly this. This probe tests whether application running in the container is in a healthy state. If not, Kubernetes kills the container and attempts to redeploy it. If the issue was related to the underlying node or collocated applications, it will definitely be fixed. If not, it buys you some time to debug the application and release a hotfix. It is useful when you want to ensure your application is not deadlocked or silently unresponsive. Here is an example of the liveness probe. You can choose to perform HTTP, TCP, or execute a local command to check the status of your app. Also, you can configure the initial delay before starting to test your app and interval. In this case, we'll run it every 5 seconds. Now, a lot of times we run some kind of client-facing apps in Kubernetes. It could be exposed to the internet using ingress or inside the cluster using a default service of type cluster IP. In this case, we want to make sure that the app is ready to accept traffic before we add it to the backend service pool. For example, the app needs to warm up and establish a connection to the database. For that, we use a readiness probe. It does not kill the container compared to the liveness probe. It simply marks it as not ready and removes port IP address from the endpoints of the service. And finally, we have the startup probe, which is typically used with legacy applications that take a very long time to start, such as some old Java applications. This probe just delays liveness and readiness probes. Liveness probes can be a powerful way to recover from application failures, but they should be configured very carefully. For example, if multiple instances fail at the same time and don't recover quickly enough, additional load spread to the remaining instances can kill the entire cluster. Properly configured health checks are also important if you autoscale your Kubernetes cluster. If you want to learn more about different approaches to autoscale your cluster and pods, you can watch this video.